A1. Day 2, S10 Blazer, 2000 S10 Blazer wrecked. We got it ripped down to the point where we can see what the real problem is. So far it looks like just the upper control arm smashed pretty good. The frame horn in the front here looks pretty good, except for where the bumper mounts. You can see twisted up a little bit compared to the driver's side. It didn't run when we brought it in. Checked everything out, checked all the wiring here in the corner, which I had to remove anyhow to put this new rad support in, if we were going to fix it. Didn't have power to the fuel pump. Fuel pump's okay, but we lost power to it. Like I said, the wiring looks good, but could be a safety from the collision. I'm not sure. I'm going to check into that a little more to see if these even have it. I don't think GM has an inertia valve or anything of that sort. Or they do have emergency shutoff if they roll over, a buddy of mine was telling me. So, as you can see, it's not a bad S10 Blazer. Bought it wrecked. Like I said, so far the frame looks pretty good. Once we get it all back together rolling, we're going to get a upper control arm on it, get it rolling good, make sure it take to the frame shop, make sure the frame's okay. Like I said, once we got power to the fuel pump wire, it runs real well, shifts and everything. So just backed it up dragging the tire. We didn't do a whole lot, but here's the inner fender well we took out. It's junk, bumper's junk, fender's junk, grill's junk, all this stuff pretty much junk. Battery was smashed. There was a fuse shorted out in a 30 amper in the front that operates this little device here. Not real sure what that little dealio is yet, but we'll figure it out too. That's what they make books and computer for. Okay, we'll see you on the next one. Okay, back from the frame shop. Got the upper control arm I put on there. Everything's A+ now. Frame's good. I gotta straighten that little horn by hand for the bumper, but wheels on. Everything's good. It's day 3. Well, I was at the junkyard getting an upper control arm. Look what I found. Black hood and a black fender. Ain't that sweet? Yep. Got a radiator, a rad support, the grill, all to pick apart. Beautiful thing. All the parts so far, $300. Buddy owns frame shop, $150. So hopefully we'll be in all this for about $1,000. Beautiful thing. See you in a little bit. Day 4. All the metal from the junkyard's on. All the body lines look pretty good, considering. You know me. Fenders are black. Mats real nice. Gap between the tires looks real well. The headlight, a little moisture in there. Take the bulbs out, let them dry out. That's the junkyard one. Gotta be real careful not to touch the bulbs. We don't want them to go bad. They work. That's the original headlight. Body line looks real nice. Door body line, real nice. A little couple of little parts put on, the plastic pieces, the whatnots, the grill, get the grill in, got Shrodica's in there, do a little more work on that horn when they get the bumper. Still didn't find a bumper yet, but we'll get all those parts and get it all buttoned up and buffed out. The next one will be pretty. Okay, there it is, from start to finish, $1,150. Bought it, had the frame pulled, bought the parts at a pick apart where I pulled them off, saved a lot of money. They were already black, so they matched. There it is. Let's do it again.